Himachal Pradesh, though an important state on the map of India, remains yet unexplored for its untapped beauty. For the adventurous in spirit, a visit into the unknown interiors of Himachal is indeed a journey to remember. Allow us to carry you along as we relive an exhilarating experience. We set out from the more tourist-tapped yet still charming Shimla for Kinnaur district. Located in the northeastern part of Himachal Pradesh, Kinnaur shares its eastern boundary with Tibet. Our driver cum guide, an ex-Himachal Roadways employee, sets the pace for the somewhat rocky road and ride ahead with humor. Kinnaur is famous for its four W's, weather, ways, wine and women, he tells us. But we discover that it is also popular for its festivals, fairs and the beautiful Naku Lake. Besides its eye-opening wildlife sanctuaries, which house the Himalayan black bear, brown bear, musk deer, goral, ibex, leopard, blue sheep and yak. The route is poetically termed Green Valley, it being one of the longest stretches of green belt area lined with apple orchards, the fruit tempting and ripe for the picking. And later, Fagu Valley, also fruit laden and famed for spotting of unusual wildlife. Fagu is placed at an elevated altitude of 2,450 meters and provides tourists with a spectacular and panoramic view of the snow-capped Himalayan mountain ranges. A surprising sight in Shilaru, in Shimla district, is a high altitude, perfectly carved among the hills, hockey ground. An unusual sports center indeed. The journey to Rekongpyu is about 250 kilometers from Shimla, and we took the shorter route via Narkanda. Though the road is fairly rocky and halts are advised in case of landslides, it cuts the distance by 70 kilometers and is a beautiful scenic route enriched with flora and fauna. The best time to visit Himachal is in summer, since the monsoon makes landslides unavoidable. Once you cross Narkanda and the Kotgarh Valley, the route gets better with the Grif area dominating. Within a few miles of Kingal, the tempting, sparkling Satluj River appears, as do the snow-clad Himalayas, with Mount Kailash predominant above other peaks, making for a breathtaking journey. On route, we cross a small village called Jalori Jot, where the road to Shrikant Mahadev bifurcates. As we approach Rampur on our way to Rekongpu, it was time to step off the highway to flow with the Satluj and a glorious view of the sunset. And around 30 kilometers ahead of Jiori, we encounter our first landslide. The PWD officer in charge, Mr. Mohan Singh, informs us that we missed it by 15 minutes. We encountered another minor landslide, but thanks to our able driver, he speeds like the wind to avoid trouble. Incidentally, should you choose to halt at Sarahan, you awaken to a promised magnificent view of the Kinar Kailash mountain range. These snow-clad peaks at close range make for the sight of a lifetime. Sarahan, also known as the gateway to Kinar, is the base for numerous treks. It is also famous for an ancient architectural structure, the Bhimakali Temple. It is roughly 15 kilometers from Jiori, the midpoint of the Shimla-Piu route. For the history of the temple's antecedents, well, we hand over the storytelling to the resident priest.
मेरा नाम ज्ञान प्रकाश
है। ये मंदिर कितना पुराना है? मंदिर
तकरीबन 600 साल का। ये इसकी खासियत ये है कि लोगों की जो मान्यता जो है यहाँ तकरीबन पूरी होती है, इसलिए लोग यहाँ पर आते हैं। ये जो हमारे पहले मुख्यमंत्री थे, इस टाइम जो है दिल्ली में जो है इस्पात मंत्री है श्री वीरभद्र सिंह जी, उनके पूर्वजों का बना है। पर्यटन के हिसाब से तकरीबन साल में मेरे ख्याल 10-20 हज़ार तो आई है।
10-20 हज़ार
आजकल ऐसा है कि अब मौसम ख़राब है, इस वजह से जो है लोगों का आना जाना बहुत मुश्किल होगा। अब नवरात्रों में काफ़ी भीड़ रहेगी और दशहरे में काफ़ी भीड़ रहेगी। इसके साथ में यहाँ जो है इस परिसर के अंदर जो है 5 मंदिर।
For the adventurous traveller to Sarahan, the Kamru Fort might be of interest, along with the bird park where pheasants are bred. It also houses the state bird Monal, which is of great attraction. And just 50 kilometres away is the beauteous Bhaba Valley, along with the Bhaba River. The link road originates at Wangtoo and boasts of beautiful landscape, a reservoir, alpine meadows, and is famous for the trekking route to Pin Valley in Spiti. But the Sangla Valley is the most charming valley in the Kinnaur district. So here we are, back on the road to destination Rekongpyu. Kailash Peak stands tall and strong, almost like a silent sentinel to this town. Incidentally, newspapers do not reach Rekongpyu till 4 or 5 days after the due date due to route inaccessibility. A few turns upslope stands the Buddhist monastery. We walk to the monastery, surrounded by apple trees and a beautiful garden. The monastery boasts of Buddhist prayer wheels that lend architectural symmetry, prayer flags, etc. With apples beckoning everywhere, it seemed only fitting to follow the trail of apple laborers in a neighboring orchard. They work hard to have this delightful fruit packed and delivered to the rest of India. But before we say too much, let's hear it from a laborer himself.
हमारे यहाँ ज़्यादा करके रॉयल डिलीशियस जाती है और पिक्चर है, रेड रॉयल है और फिर सफर भी अब चला हुआ है जी. बाकी ज़्यादा ये भी डिलीशियस है. अगर हमने ये रेलवे को दिया हुआ है,
अच्छा
रेलवे से हमने वो एग्रीमेंट बनाया हुआ है, वो हमारा सेफ लेंगे.
Though our plan had a visit to Namgya and Sangla written all over it, major landslides and rains had blocked the roads for a day. So nature, once again, dictated to mankind, and this was not possible. A traditional ritual in a Kalpa temple apparently holds good for neighboring villages too. The destruction caused by the monsoon this year had them praying for the safety and prosperity of their village. They carry their deity to its birthplace and even perform rituals of intermarrying deities from neighboring villages, bathing them in wine, etc.
आज ये ऐसा था कि किन्नौर में आज तक इतनी लंबी अरसा में बारिशें नहीं हुई थी. इस दफा लगातार 3-4 महीने बारिशों से बुरे हाल हुआ, तो इसलिए उत्तराखंड के जितने देवी देवता हैं उसी हिसाब से हमारे किन्नौर में भी हर गांव में देवी देवता, ईष्ट देवी देवता है. तो हमारे इस एरिया में सबसे बड़े देवता ब्रह्मा विष्णु जी हमारे कल्पा के और देवी चंडिका जी कोठी के सबसे बड़े हैं. बाकी हमारे नाग देवता हैं. इस तरह से 10 देवते इकट्ठे होके पिछले ये संडे को जो है जो ब्रह्मा विष्णु का जन्म स्थान है पीओ में, वहाँ पर पूजा पाठ किया. उसके बाद ये बारिश रुक गई है. उसी सिलसिले में हम लोग वहाँ से 4 दिनों के बाद हम वापस अपने मंदिर आते देवी देवताओं को जो है यहाँ अपने मंदिर में ला दिए है.
हमने देखा कि जब वो गाना गा रहे थे तो गाने में वो क्या बोलते हैं भगवान को, क्या
भगवान के अपने गुण हैं, जैसे कि रामायण में है, रामचंद्र जी के हैं, सीता जी के हैं, वैसे जैसे गाने बने हैं वैसे इन ईष्ट देवताओं के भी गाने बने हुए हैं. अपने अपने बने वही गाना कहा कि इनको प्रसन्न करते हैं. जब ये प्रसन्न हो जाते हैं तो जो हमारे जो दुख दर्द है वो समाधान हो जाता है. अब इतने दिनों से बारिशें नहीं रुक रही थी तो सबसे हादसी रुक गई.
And as all good things often have a habit of coming to an end, it was time to head back to Shimla. Coming back to utter civilization gives one mixed feelings. You have left behind the threatening forces of nature. Yet, you miss the beauty of awesome mountain peaks, beautiful valleys, rare flora and fauna, and rugged terrain. Yet, one can't complain. Down the Mal Road of Shimla, in the early hours of the morning, comes the comforting peal of a church bell. It reminds you that there is indeed an awesome God who created this fascinating state that is Himachal Pradesh.